Midjourney finally have added Omni Reference. Now we can create consistent character, and by the end of the video I will do a detailed comparison between Omni Reference of Midjourney and FluxDev LoRA output by the end of the video. So now let's dive into Midjourney Omni Reference. Once you visit Midjourney page, if you click on this add image icon, you can see lot of options here: image prompt, style reference, and Omni Reference. This is the one we are talking about. This is for the style reference and this is for image reference. For the first example, let's use this portrait. So to use this as Omni Reference, just drag and these options will appear. Just drop it in the Omni Reference and I'll show you all the comparison with different values. Let's use the default 100 strength for the Omni Reference. So this is my prompt: a girl sitting on a bench in a magical park. I'm using Midjourney version 7. Version 7 is amazing. Yeah, these are the results. It have tried to keep the face consistent. The face is wider in this image as compared to the reference image. Let's add the same image, make the value 700 for example, and add the same prompt and click generate. This set of images looks more close to the reference character. This is a detailed comparison. The first image is the main reference image for Omni Reference, and these are the results with different strength. First I started with the value 10 and then I kept increasing 100, 400 and all these, so you can have a better understanding by seeing this comparison. Now let's try with a different creature, like it's a cute octopus. Let's add this image as Omni Reference and value to 700. Cute octopus on a study table. Dramatic lighting and generate. Yeah, the character looks quite similar, but it have changed the color and these images are over sharpened by Midjourney. I don't know why. And it was a simple prompt also. Now let's try adding an image of my face. This is a real photograph selfie. It's not AI generated. I've added this image. Now let's add that to Omni Reference. It's added. Now let's write a prompt: portrait of a man in a sci-fi movie scene. Let's generate. It have generated this set of images. You can see none of these faces are not close to how I look. It's close enough, but it's different. It have taken the overall structure, overall hairstyle and everything, but it's not me. So let's try with a higher value. Let's make it 1000. It's not me. I don't know. It's doing a pretty good job than like image guidance, which was there in Midjourney previously, but it's not at all accurate to get a consistent character of any real life person. I don't know, is it for security purpose or they are not capable of producing that, but all faces are different, quite different. And this set of images with the Omni Reference strength to 1000, this is also close to me but not me, but it's quite close to each other. As it was a real photograph, try with the image of me that I have already generated using FluxDev. This is the image. It looks exactly like me. This is generated after training a LoRA model with my faces. I have shared the entire process of how to train your own custom LoRA model with your own face. The link of the video, it will pop somewhere here. I'll add the link for that video in the description also. And I'll comparing FluxDev LoRA output with Midjourney output by the end of the video. I'll be using the same prompt: Omni Reference and the value 2000. Generate. It have generated and the faces still looks different from my actual reference image. So you can see this is quite close, I would say. One eye is looking forward and another eye is looking little bit upward. It's distorted. This looks completely different. This also looks completely different. And this is not at all okay. Let's try with 400. And this looks kind of better than what we were getting at 1000. It's lot more closer to the reference image. This is not. I like this one and this one. But I don't know, why is it using the background of this image? Now let's add this same image as image prompt. Use the same prompt. So let's see how Omni Reference is doing and what image prompt is doing. Let's see. Or is it a bluff? No, it's not a bluff. It has generated a completely different image. Yes, the Omni Reference is not a bluff, but it's not that accurate. So I think we have to keep playing with this value. 100 value. Images looks good. I like this image. Yeah, this looks quite close to my face. This one also, and even this one. It is quite close to my reference image, but please Midjourney, do something in text generation. But I see the angle of these faces are almost similar to the reference image. Once it have created a different angle, the face looks different. Whenever it's trying to create a different angle, it's generating a completely different facial structure. I don't know what type of fighting is going on. I feel like they are dating. These two characters are dating with each other. They are in love. It feels like that. So dramatic. Such a dramatic image. Oh my god. Cool. Now let's compare this with FluxDev. So I've trained my LoRA model using FluxDev LoRA trainer in Replicate. I've shared the entire process in detail and it's very simple. And I'll add the link of the video in the description and it will pop somewhere here. Now let's try. We'll be using the same prompt here also, but we have to add portrait of a man, ARYA, because ARYA is the token word to call my LoRA model. I'm going to use seed value of 1111. Say you'd have generated these two images. This looks exactly like me. See the background, it have created a proper sci-fi movie scene. I am not adding any image reference here as the entire model is trained on my face, so it knows my face, and I'm calling my trained model using this token word ARYA. I'm using a simple prompt and it's generating such accurate representation of my face, and this is how I look exactly. I love this. And I trained the model, it cost me $2, $1.98 something, and I kept generating lots of images, hundreds of images, almost $5 after generating so many images, and these images are so accurate. So what my views is, if you are trying to create something generic or like specific one or two images, then you can go for Midjourney Omni Reference. But if you are thinking of creating a proper film where the characters are consistent, or a TVC ad type of campaigns where the characters are the most important thing, I think it's better to train your own custom model and you will have a consistent character throughout the film. Then I would go surely with FluxDev LoRA. Let me know your views. Please do comment down below. I think this video have helped you to understand which tool works for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll be back with a new video soon. Bye bye.